What's going on, Clutch?
What?
What up?
What up?
It's your boy Ross.
And we are in the
Clutch.
Hey, back to ladies and gentlemen of the visitor that you feel me.
10 outrageous Vince McMahon moments. Vince, it's Vince. He's known for
Durag
outrageous Vince. Moments, especially seen on live television. That's just an extension of him.
What's up, my nigga?
Yeah, that's Vince for
crazy,
you.
Crazy, right?
That's Vince for you. So we're going to check out some of Vince McMahon's outrageous moments. I'm sure there's plenty more other than 10.
But these are just the top 10.
Of course, man. Let's get right into this one. Shout out to the homie Wrestling Flashback, man.
Yeah, run up the likes, man.
Mm-hmm. Is this on?
Whether it's through his real life or on-screen antics, Vince McMahon will always be one of wrestling's most controversial men. Mm-hmm. He's been involved in so many crazy segments and matches over the years, but today, we've narrowed it down as we look at this 10 outrageous Vince McMahon moments on WWE TV. Before we start the list, let's run through some honorable mentions. McMahon has been no stranger to getting down and dancing over the years, but he was at his best during the 1987 Sammy Awards, performing
yes,
Stand Back, this where he was accompanied by choreographed dancers and numerous wrestlers
fucking
dog. Look at this, bro.
One of the most legendary moments in Raw history occurred in October 1998 when McMahon lay in a hospital bed after having his ankle broken by The Undertaker and Kane the previous week. It led to the debut of Mr. Socko and Stone Cold Steve Austin coming in, raining down shots on Vince's injured ankle before smashing a bedpan over the boss's head.
When Steve grabbed the bedpan, Steve just grabbed shit that was near him and hit Vince with the bedpan and about killed him.
I don't think it's gonna hurt that much, but this is fucking thing is thick as it. Of course, when it's showtime, you don't even think about it. That was fun.
You heard that.
In 2001, Vince began to make out with Trish Stratus on TV, while McMahon's wife Linda was wheelchair bound in a zombie-like state.
Like,
but things truly hit the fan
state.
When Vince made there Trish bark like a dog and strip live on Raw.
This was unreal.
I'm trying to realize, bro. This is what we
were
watching as kids.
She was like in a coma, bro.
And this boy was making out with Trish.
She had to pretend to just...
He was living every man's dream.
That, bro, Vince.
And living out his dream.
Oh, he was definitely living out his dream behind the scenes.
Imagine being able to be in control of stuff like that. And you, hey, me and her got to have sex in order to kind of tell a story. Story got to be real, babe. And your wife go along with it.
Oh, my
she
God.
She don't have a choice.
That was funny, bro.
Covered Trish in dirty mop water at one point.
I knew that the way it was presented to me that I would get mine in the end, and I did. So it turned out to be a memorable moment and a necessary moment for what we were creating.
At the same time, he was in a rivalry with his son, Shane McMahon, saying and doing some of the most heinous things you can imagine as a father.
I will never ever forgive your mother for giving birth to you.
Oh, this is close.
This is bad enough, but it doesn't even scratch the surface when it comes to the crazy things that Vince has scripted himself to do on television. Number 10, gets naked for Tori Wilson. Vince certainly enjoyed making out with countless women on television.
Look at this, man.
Attracted to women, love women.
But the Ms. McMahon character was prepared to take it one step further on the July 2nd Raw from 2001. On the show, Vince appeared with Tori Wilson backstage and questioned how badly she wanted to become a WWF superstar. And it became clear that Vince could make this happen, provided Tori made love with him. Although, despite several attempts, the two were continuously interrupted. First by Stone Cold whilst in the shower, then by Kurt Angle in a mop closet, and also by Perry Saturn in a bathroom.
Bro.
Vince and Tori then made their way to the laundry room where they finally had some privacy. Tori began to undress Vince and then asked him to close his eyes. McMahon obliged only for a few seconds to pass before he opened his eyes again. And when he did, staring back at Vince was his wife Linda, looking on in disgust.
And I've got a big surprise for you.
Bro.
This is a real thing.
Vince tried to play it off as if he was doing his laundry, but Vinnie Mac had been caught with his pants down. Number 9, screaming in the announcer's ears. Vince screaming in the commentator's ears was an unfortunate staple of WWE programming for many years.
Yep.
It's forced some announcers to outright quit the company because of the constant tirade of abuse over the headset, including the likes of Taz and the hardcore legend Mick Foley.
Look at Batista's face. It's nothing but pure hatred, a mask of unbridled hatred. And then I hear that voice go, "That's enough with that effing hate word." And I went, I'm not used to being treated like this, right? If that was part of the job, I didn't want any part of it.
Renee Paquette cited a specific moment when she knew she was done with the WWE after Vince screamed in her ear,
"The Gypsy King Tyson Fury throwed a package, and he's in my ear and goes, 'You fucking ruined it!' Screaming at me, telling me that I've ruined this segment because I did not refer to Tyson Fury as the lineal champion. At that point, I knew that I was kind of like, I am out of here, man." Mm-hmm.
Since Vince has stepped away from creative duties, the commentary on WWE has improved significantly, with Michael Cole especially being given a new lease of life, as Cole had previously been the worst victim when it came to McMahon yelling at the announce team.
"Hey, Vince, if you want me to say that every time, because I said this shitload of times to win. Okay.
It's called,
yes, sir. So you
want?
Yes, sir.
Michael Cole, shut up."
Michael Cole, 25 years into this thing, almost
horrible human being.
Number 8. He would have definitely caught one. He would have been in there for real. Times, but his only ever arrests have come on television, including in 1998 and 2015. However, his most entertaining arrest went down on the November 22nd Raw in 1999. Vince sought revenge on DX, and especially Triple H, after they tormented the McMahon family the previous week in numerous ways. Vince was hell-bent on getting payback, and did so by ramming and destroying D-Generation X's limo. McMahon also tried to break down the door of DX's locker room, but was apprehended and arrested by the police. Vince was then booked and processed in the county jail before being put in a cell. Vince posted bail just in time to return for the main event, where he closed the show by attacking Triple H, throwing him off the stage to the floor below.
Oh my God.
Number 7, pees and poos his pants on live TV. Stone Cold Steve Austin's torment of Vince led to some truly epic moments, one of which was the time on Raw in October 1998 when Austin held a gun to McMahon's head. A terrified Vince was almost crying in fear, only for Stone Cold to reveal he was wielding a toy gun. However, Vince had already peed his pants, creating one of the funniest segments in WWE history.
"McMahon 316. Says I just pissed my pants."
Vince has had a few toilet mishaps over the years, including the time he defecated himself in a hospital bed on Raw. However, there was one time in which Vince legit pooed his pants while trying to get Gerald Briscoe to puke. This happened backstage before McMahon went to the ring for a live promo, as JR revealed in a radio interview in 2014.
"He turns his back to Briscoe to deposit something a little in the air, and it got liquid. He
Number 6, Durag Vince. What? The Battle of the Billionaires between Vince Durag and Donald Trump spawned one of the all-time WrestleMania moments, as Vince's head was shaped completely bald. We all love to see Vince get his comeuppance. He played it brilliantly with great facial expressions and hilarious cries for help. But what came in the following weeks was hilarious. As Vince began to rock a durag and decided to tweak up his character a little, McMahon began referring to people as G and Holmes, incorporating various elements of black culture into his gimmick for a truly interesting result.
"What's up, Holmes? What up, G?
Come on.
Man, look like he's about to break his damn arm, bro. Dog, he walking like his arm was broke. Look at this.
Come on.
Weekend at Bernie's.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
Sweet. Yeah. No. Number 5, gets his head shoved up Rikishi's ass. The Vince McMahon Kiss My Ass Club was born in 2001 and has featured a host of different members, so it was all the more sweeter when Vince got his own head shoved up the biggest ass in wrestling. This went down on the December 6th.
It's just some shit you'll never catch me doing. I don't give a damn for what segment. I ain't doing it.
Yeah, I'm good on that, Coach.
I'm straight, Coach. To whatever other wrestling company I gotta go to, but I will not.
Episode of SmackDown in 2001. Vince was under the impression that he was going to be kissing Trish's ass.
"Go kiss that ass!
Yeah, French kiss!
Dog,
However, McMahon was instead met by the returning Rikishi. The Rock then proceeded to bury Vince's face into Big Kish's backside to cap off a truly classic segment.
That's cold, bro.
Vince has always said he wouldn't ask his talent to do anything McMahon wouldn't do himself, and Vince proved this by not only getting his head shoved up Rikishi's ass, but Big Show's as well during a Hell in a Cell match at Unforgiven 2006, when Vince teamed up with Big Show and Shane McMahon in a losing effort against DX.
"Suck it, Eddie!
Number four blows out both his quads at the 2005 Royal Rumble. Vince is well known for losing his cool, and his fiery temper was on display for all to see during the closing stages of the 2005 Rumble match. This was as a result of a botched ending to the match, where John Cena and Batista were both eliminated at the same time. The referees bought time by raising each man's hand. McMahon then furiously power walked down the aisle, throwing his jacket to the ground and awkwardly sliding into the ring. He tried to get to a vertical base, but the chairman had already blown out both of his quads at the same time whilst entering the ring. And as he sat there on the mat, Vince directed traffic, telling the referees and wrestlers to restart the match with the final two, Cena and Batista. The match finished as normal with Batista winning. Vince was somehow able to walk to the back on his own 2 feet before collapsing once he got through the curtain. All in all, it was an outrageous moment that sums up just how angry, insane, and tough McMahon
listen to me.
That was very unique. Not too many people can, you know, sever, you know, the quad tendons at the same time.
Yeah. At the same
because
time.
Because you have no use of your legs at all.
Speaking of McMahon being tough, over the years, he's taken some ridiculous bumps.
Yeah.
Oh my damn.
I'm gonna spill on all four. He's spill on all four.
He's not an athlete.
CTE stuff.
Damn.
Oh. Damn. Oh,
bro, Vince. Vince was taking some spots, bro.
Yeah, he was.
Look at this.
Woo! Man, the rest of the on his way out. On his way out.
Blows himself up in a limo. From involuntary blowing out both of his quads to purposely blowing himself up in a limousine. Vince has always tried to find ways of writing himself off television, but the chairman had perhaps found a way of getting off TV for good. On the June 11th, 2007 edition of Raw, at the end of the show, Vince would step into his limo, only to be seemingly blown to smithereens in one of the craziest ever conclusions to Monday Night Raw.
Like, bro, did we just watch this nigga die?
Right.
The following week, the WWE was set to pay their respects to Vince McMahon in a special 3-hour episode of Raw. However, these plans were scrapped following the Benoit family tragedy, leading to Vince reappearing at the start of the show and thus cancelling the limo explosion storyline. Number two, wrestling.
I'm here. I'm
Vince
really here.
Vince has had his fair share of matches in the WWE, many of which were violent and bloody, but few were more shocking than when Vince and Shane McMahon teamed up to wrestle Shawn Michaels and God at Backlash 2006. In the build-up to the match, Vince devised his own religion, McMahonism.
And the name of it is McMahonism.
He also cut a blasphemous promo from inside a church.
Blessed be the name of
Vince. I remember that.
McMahon.
I just knew
it was
Hill
also a skit where Vince healed Candice Michelle.
Heal this woman's breast.
What the hell was that?
Once it came time for the match, Vince introduced God down to the ring, equipped with a spotlight and funky music, which Vince, of course, danced along to.
McMahon wants God to get jiggy with it.
With Shawn set to jump off a ladder onto Vince and Shane below, the Spirit Squad interfered, putting HBK through a table, allowing Vince to make the cover and ultimately get the victory for he and Shane. Number one, wrestling his daughter. Wrestling God is bad enough, but how about booking yourself in a match against your own daughter just days before her wedding?
I think my mom, I was absolutely livid. My brother.
I mean, are you crazy?
And my husband.
This is ridiculous.
Were more upset about it than I was.
Well, this is what Vince did at No Mercy 2003 in his first ever right father her versus wedding. Daughter I Quit match. The two managed to have a compelling match that had plenty of heat and featured
he always wanted to do
shots.
That.
Oh, here she comes! Big
and also interference from Sable and Linda McMahon. The finish came when Vince began to choke Stephanie with a lead pipe. This left Linda with no choice but to throw in the towel on behalf of her daughter, which therefore gave Vince the win. After the bell, Vince pie-faced Linda to the ground, closing out one of WWE's most surreal matches. Vince McMahon is loved and hated by many. Through his on-screen and off-screen controversies, he remains perhaps wrestling's most polarizing figure.
I've never thought that my dad's gone too far on television. When my dad goes for it, it's great.
Vince has said before that once his time is up, he wants one last moment to say thank you to everyone.
Daddy's coming home!
So with that in mind, we'll close things out by saying thank you to Vince.
Thank you, Vince.
F you, Vince. F you, Vince.
And that brings us to the end of this video. As always, if you enjoyed the video, be sure.
Yeah, bro. Vince needed help. We was watching like a mental problem live for all those years. He just didn't care.
What up, my dog?
What's up, G? What?
Vince, what is this?
Show me the wave so I know it's real.
What up, my nigga? I'm like,
you wouldn't know what to think. I could imagine what, like, our parents would have thought walking in on us during that segment.
What up, my nigga?
What the hell did you just say?
Live television. They didn't bleep it out or nothing, bro. That was live.
Vince lucky that we didn't have social media back then, like now.
Hey, bro. Wrestling was different, bro.
He would have been out of here.
Wrestling was so much different, bro. Oh, my goodness.
Those were top 10 outrageous moments, man. Shout out to the homie on Wrestling Flashback, man.
Yeah, shout out to the homie, man. And he actually, it was like maybe I think last year, he had, I think he made like a video talking about us checking out some of his content or whatnot. He started really posting compilations of old school wrestling stuff during the pandemic, and that's how his platform grew. And we was you know, one of the people that checked out some of his stuff. So, hey, man, shout out to you, bro. Yeah, keep doing your thing, man.
For real, keep doing your thing. Keep, you know, running it up. And got our support over here, man.
For sure.
If y'all enjoyed it, you already know what to do. Make sure you run up to like, subscribe. Also, go to the original link. The original video is down below. Make sure you go hit them with a like, hit them with a subscription as well, man. Keep on supporting. But we love you guys. Continue to spread love, be love out there. Don't be like Vince.
Please don't.
Please don't. Catch y'all on the next one. Peace out.
Already.
Vince's from Houston. If you got a problem, then we got the solutions. And there's no illusion. I made this shit happen. I'm living life lucid. I'm switching my strategies. Now they hate on me because I'm causing casualties. But why are they after me? Deep inside, they know they can't handle half of me.